So that's an important distinction because it takes time to build up that synergy and make your veteran status actually be relevant.
Elephant Gang hadn't managed to make it in last time for season 9, so.
Yeah. So where we're going to be playing, it's going to be Border.
All right. Good map. Should
it is
fun.
Indeed a good map.
At least it's not Cafe again.
Some people, you know, it's starting to fall out of favor. I've noticed a lot of people, yeah. A lot of pros are kind of calling that one into question. I remember way back in the beginning, for the first like 2 months of Border existing, people hated it.
And yeah. It took like a whole season to catch up.
Yeah, and it became like the best map ever.
It was like that with Coastline too. Like, yeah. I mean, I don't think people hated it, but it took time to catch on as well.
Anyway. Became the best map ever, and you know, as time progresses, these smaller maps, simpler maps, they get figured out fully, and teams start to dislike it. But I don't know, we're not fully there with Border. Well, let's see. What do you guys think? Who's gonna win this? Oh, okay.
Wow! Only 21% for a draw?
Yeah, only 21. It should have probably been 30%.
It was 22, I believe, last matchup. So definitely some. This is where the draws come out. Is when SSG is playing draw votes.
Yeah, it's not crazy. It's not crazy surprising that the draw is so high with SSG being involved. It doesn't really matter who they're playing against.
Yeah. In this case, though, the Sonics have a lot to try and make up for in terms of just really struggling. They were higher placed than Luminosity in Challenger League, but at the same time, I don't think they came swinging into relegations as hard as they would have liked, and showing that despite being a lot of former Pro League players, they're still struggling to play against Pro League compared to Challenger League teams, it seems.
Yeah, they've had a rough one so far. They certainly have. And going up against SSG, I think it's going to be a really... I think this is going to be a hard match for them. I would honestly agree with this community vote to an extent. You know, I'm looking at it and I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, Space Station could easily draw it as Space Station does. But the way I'm thinking about it is it's kind of in the hands of Space Station.
Yeah.
Like, the way I see this match is very much, it's Space Station have control here.
They're in the driver's seat, for sure.
They're in the driver's seat, and it's their match to lose, it's their match to draw, and it's their match to win. So we'll see what they can pull out here, and we'll see if Sonics are going to give us an upset, because there's always potential for that. I mean, you know, as much as they haven't had a good season so far, there's a lot of skill in that roster. There's a lot of potential. Yeah. It's the same thing with TSM, you know. Not a great season, not living up to the expectations just yet, but...
Potential.
The talent is there. You just gotta wait and see. Capitao and Buck gonna be the first bands out here.
So that means Half Wall now 1,000 times safer than it used to be.
I mean, it's still Sophia and Ash, but yeah, Buck is a very common ban on Border recently I've been finding.
Yeah.
This
reminds me of the Pulse bans as well in terms of like playing from below kinds of things.
Yeah.
I mean, that's on the opposite side, but still.
I know what you mean. Yeah, I gotcha.
Maestro going to go instead of Echo, though, so that should be interesting for the actual push coming out.
I think Maestro ban's sensible. It's a pretty typical North American ban. And last season, he was the top defendant. Yeah, I think he was the top ban defender in North America. Because it was like, North America ban Maestro, Latin America ban Echo, and Europe ban Mira.
Yeah, Echo's, I think, picked up a little bit in terms of a ban as well. But I don't know. Let me look here. I'm not seeing... ton of Maestro, but definitely I think 3 or so Maestros in the last 3 play days. So it's like 1 a day.
This is less common than it was last season, that's for sure.
Yeah.
I'm very much taking a downturn there.
Oh, the Lion.
Oh boy. Instead of a Nomad, you're going to be a Lion. Well, okay.
I don't know. On this particular map,
I was about to say the exact same thing. The Nomad air jabs are so good here.
This is one of the example maps people would use when they were explaining why they thought Nomad was a little bit OP. Especially when it didn't take the delay to set it up, and you could hit it just over half wall, for example.
I mean, like, okay, let's say you take control of CCTV, right? You have control of CCTV, you put one air jab on the break room door,
yep.
Bam, CCTV health.
Room's locked down.
Yeah, I mean, they could impact the wall by 90, but...
That's
going to broadcast their flank, so they're not going to do that.
Yeah, that's about the same as just running into the air jab, practically.
Yeah, pretty much. So, all right, well...
Vents to start with.
You know, the Lion's still good, though. I mean, we can't refute that. And Vents to start with is quite interesting, like you say, in that, normally people go to Armory first.
Yeah, for good reason. But it surprises me even more, because, again, the bans favor Half Wall. With no Buck and no Capitao, it's a lot harder to take out people behind Half Wall in terms of utility-wise. I mean, there's still plenty of ways to do things to them, but, again, no grenades in play either outside of the Zofia's lifeline, so... Yeah, Half Wall would have been pretty safe.
Well, I mean, it's done now.
Yeah, well, they'll play it eventually, I imagine.
We are where we are right now. Ghost going to try and take control of Passport, or at least open up the door, though I imagine he's going to go for the push if he actually opens the door. Usually that's what you follow up with. Information is abundant for Space Station so far. I'm just waiting. Playing the patient game here. Sonics. I'm not really sure what they're trying to do. I'm imagining this is a CCTV take. You get CCTV control, then you can get customs control by extension. Once you have that, you have a nice crossfire in sight if you decide to hit B. And that seems to be the play right now. Clear. They're also going to have to take care of Armory if that's the case, though. Yeah. And if they do have Thinking, I believe it is, contesting Armory by half wall. The Armory wall was just opened up there by the Hamana, though, so things are going smoothly for Sonic so far.
Just slowly.
Yeah, smoothly, but also slowly. Oh, no, I was wrong. Armory wall not opened up, so not so smooth here.
Yeah, they also don't have a Thermite, so they're going to have to use a few X-Kairos to do that.
I mean, it's not the end of the world. As long as you get a line of sight onto half wall, you can pressure half wall from two angles. Now, here's the thing. Okay, they have CC control, and they're using CC control to, you know, get custom control so that they can crossfire B and cut off rotation. Sure, that's fine. That's great. But if they want to actually plant a B, they have to get Armory control. So, well, at least half wall control. So that's the next step. Here comes the Sonics. Space Station still holding onto Armory fast.
Ooh, Faults with a nice kill there on a Ghost sticking out. Might have used some of that utility already, but that's a great kill before rotating back. A little bit risky for a smoke to be doing, but
yeah, it is certainly risky, but it worked out, so there you go. Space Station, a little bit of aggression there, poking the enemy, coming out on top. SSGs still have control of Armory, and it doesn't seem like Sonics are really, I mean, just kind of waiting outside of Armory.
Yeah, this is a little bit slow to be starting to make a push for Armory at 35 seconds left.
And they'll be punished thanks to the gas canisters and the great peek there from Thinking Nade. When you use the EE1D, it broadcasts your intents, and SSG are ready to receive you. It's just Goddess now, and there she goes. Space Station, a flawless round to start things off.
I feel like they might as well have just renamed Armory Dining Hall because all they did was continue to feed SSG in there.
That's a nice one. I like that one.
Okay, cool. Right on. That was, I mean,
because you're right.
It was nice at first, but it turned pretty terrible.
So, I mean, the part about that was nice there for Sonics was the part where Sonics wasn't contending with anybody, wasn't fighting anybody,
mm-hmm.
where they got a bunch of free ground.
Yeah.
That was the nice part. When Sonics didn't have to fight with anybody, everything was looking good.
Well, maybe that was SSG's doing rather more so than Sonics is doing.
I mean, yeah, it was just SSG wasn't trying to contest CCTV. That's fine. They're allowed to give up CCTV. That
certainly worked.
Yeah. Following that, Sonics tried to push into Armory. Space Station were ready. And it was a really easy hold. The EE1D broadcasted the intents, of Sonics. In the last 30 seconds, when your gas can... By the way, last 30 seconds, yes, CCTV control, you're pushing into Armory, you can't even get to site. Like, yeah. Actually, there's not time for that anymore.
You're going to have to, like, try and drop a hatch at best.
And that's not going to... No, that's not going to happen. There's no way that they, like...
drop small off his hatch or something.
Right, but then you're going to get...
Yeah, no, you're
too
just...
Too many, like, layers. Too many layers.
Well, kill yourself at that point.
Whoa.
I mean, like, in the game, obviously.
I know what you meant. I was just poking you there, buddy. But, no, okay, yeah, so... Yeah, overall, that attack, I mean, there were too many layers for Sonics to get past after they had established control of CCTV and they hadn't even started peeling yet.
Yeah.
There was no progress made, essentially.
Maybe they were just checking the monitors in CCTV, hoping to get something out of there.
It wasn't a very efficient take there.
No.
A spawn peek there from Space Station onto a spawn where no one is.
Making sure.
Just checking.
Now he knows they didn't spawn there.
Yep, that's true. Well, Sonics, where are you going to take control of now? Where's the first step for you on an Armory take? Last time it was CCTV.
Yeah.
It'll be here.
Well, hopefully it's faster than last time, because even if they were going for Armory last time, they still wouldn't have much time to do it.
And they also wouldn't have been successful.
Yeah.
One thing that's really interesting is the fact that they're bringing a Hibana continuously in lieu of a Thermite.
Which is funny, because Thermite's useful on every single site.
I've actually seen Thermite be a pretty common ban on Border.
Yeah, if you want to really deny breaches.
Yeah, Thermite is a good ban on Border.
Yeah.
And it's because he is definitely a better hard breacher here.
Well, there's every single site has a wall that's useful for Thermite to get. Oh, that's ADS taking a...
You know, you're right.
It's always ironic.
Yeah, it's every wall.
Yeah.
every site.
Even like bathroom, for example.
I actually took a second to like really think through it, but yeah, every single site. Yeah. EE1D goes off here, and it will be ineffectual as, but nobody was following it up.
Okay.
Got three of them though, so.
I guess he's gonna need three of them.
So usually, what the EE1Ds will be used for are either during a push or post plant or during a plant or something like that, but. I'm guessing they just wanted to make sure they wouldn't be pushed for one particular transition that we didn't see.
Maybe they were setting something up and just didn't want to have to cut the flank.
Yeah, no risk. It's not necessary.
Yeah.
So Foltz is in a position to use his gas canister there through the wall, and he's going to do that. Just put it in the little corner. That way default plant is denied. He's only got a minute left to delay, so that's, yeah, it's all his job is. You can see him doing it right now. It's a really effective way to deny the push in through the doorway.
He is out of them, though, with a minute left, so he's going to depend a bit more on his shotgun. And
wait, he's got one more.
I thought he just used that one.
Nah.
Well, that was pre-placed.
Yeah. So he's got one more, and he's just waiting. But, yeah, they were very early gas canisters. I would agree with you.
I guess if you have one more left, that's fine, considering how badly Sonic's pushed last time, and at least they get trade onto Foltz this time.
And it's going to be Neptunes with two big kills there, pushing into small office. He's got control of the A-bomb site, and it looks like it'll be a successful plant, but Chalo might have a Yokai drone in a position to deny this, despite the IQ being in play. And Bosco C4 from below will miss. Avian having some massive plays right now. 20 seconds is not enough time for a lone Yokai to deny this plant. So, or it's too much time, pardon.
Oh,
plant will come down there, and Chalo now will have to retake on four attackers. Not an easy feat. One at the top of metal, one playing the long angle by CCTV, door rappel, and Neptunes in small office gets his third kill. The Sonics. Nice attack there. On to Armory. Though it be delayed, there wasn't much from Space Station to actually halt it.
No, it seemed like they were kind of counting on them pushing in the situation where they were able to kind of counter it a little bit better. Burning some of the smokes a bit too early might have not helped with that as well.
I think that was a big part, the smoke was not played well.
Because they knew that. You know, they were counting the smokes, and they were like, you know what, time for EE1D, let's push. Yeah. It was just down to timing. But I do think sometimes Neptunes is one of the more slept on players as well, and he played very well that round. I think when he has the right moments, he's a very strong player. And that was definitely his moment.
Certainly was. Really big play there, pushing in through the rotation that was made in the small office wall, I believe by the Zofia. The gas canisters, again, bad pacing there for Space Station Gaming. They started too early, and he realized he started too early, so he stopped on the third one and didn't ever let it detonate.
Yeah.
Now back to Armory we go. Space Station, gonna need to work some magic, change some things here on how they choose to defend this site.
Yep.
The ban on the Maestro not working out for them so great, as the IQ has been brought every round by the Sonics to counter the Yokai drones from Echo.
Still wasn't the worst. It was almost able to get it. He just missed time. Like, Chala didn't have the right timing on the second one last time.
I'm guessing the second one, he didn't expect it to still be alive, to be honest.
Yeah, and I think he was a little concerned about getting flanked right at that moment.
Yeah, so it happens. Yeah, it's done now.
Oh, he couldn't get it quite on top of that. It's a good place to hide it.
Yep.
Save it for later.
It'd be harder for the IQ to shoot it there.
Yeah.
And look,
what? Okay, did he accidentally drive it outside? Somehow? Like over that vent top?
Maybe.
Well, that was interesting. Now maybe not the best spot to put it.
I'm guessing, maybe he bumped one of the rails and then bumped his yokai too high and the map perceived it as
outside. One of those ones where when you spawn street in Oregon, you can like throw stuff kind of into a weird abyss right by the wall.
But that wouldn't make any sense, because if you go outside with your... It would have had to perceive it as outside of the map. Not outside of the building, but outside of the map.
Yeah, very, very true. Interesting.
Because if it was outside of the building, then it would have been... it would have been get your drone back inside. Darn it.
So firm.
Okay, so a really weird... Really weird. Anyway, there's one yokai. He's got another. We don't even know if technically it was destroyed. It could have been a spectator bug, for all we know.
Very, very true.
But...
We'll see, as they are at least using one line EE1D now to help get position. They're doing a little bit more efficient job this time. They've got CCTV. They've got to start to make the push now. They're going to know that the Echo's going to be in play again. They're going to have to spot it beforehand with the IQ and plan for that. Maybe even hit it with a stun from the Thatcher when they're actually going to go for the plant, potentially.
All right, it looks like the Yokai drone is still there.
Okay.
Either that or they replaced the other one, but yeah, you could see it by the vent right now.
Well, that's good.
Thanks to Neptune on his gadget.
Spotting it for us.
Yep, and the call will come out. Sonics will be aware. Ooh. The bad block on the EMP makes it ineffective. The ADSs will persist inside a small office.
Yep. More ADSs doing some work there. Bosco actually on the roam downstairs has his C4. Could be a late game changer there. A little bit of damage on Foltz, though, I imagine, from the Zofia lifelines again. Trying to set up for that push. Hopefully he has more smokes this time.
Yeah, he's just going to start slowly putting out that smoke. As we hit the last minute, that's when he's going to begin his pacing. So if you do last minute with the smoke, you're going to have some intervals where there is no smoke up. You know, 15 seconds here and there where there's nothing to hold the enemy at bay. And I'm sure that he's accounted for that and he's ready. EE1D, the second one, ineffective. But the peak from Rampy is going to give the Sonics an opening here. And Shala will also be down. That means no Yokai drones in terms of plant denial. Foltz has no gas canisters. Plant going down by half wall. The peak from Foltz ineffective. And EE1D forces him to stand still. This is really bad from Foltz. And the plant goes down here. No one to deny it as Shala was on the floor. SSG now have to retake post-plant. Goddess will take down Foltz inside of small as she knew he was there. Super easy holdout onto Bosco elsewhere and Thinking Nade trying to retake with a C4, but it won't land. Goddess gets another, and it's just Thinking in a 1v5. Not going to be a flawless round at least, so SSG can say that, but this is still going to be a very hard retake for Thinking. Expects one in the corner. There isn't anyone there. Gets a second onto Neptune's pistol out, goes for the third, and he misses the headshot onto Ghost. The Sonics, another successful attack onto Armory, and they are looking strong right now.
Foltz in that office, not really working out. You saw that time he was even blocked by his own toxic gas in spotting the thermite we're running across.
Yeah, so I'll add to what you're, well, I'm not add, but just double down on what you're saying, basically. Foltz seems like a fish out of water playing smoke in that position.
Yeah. It seems like the reinforcement even is working against him.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know about that, but...
just in his limited visibility.
But the thing that really stands out to me for Foltz is his smokes are really ineffective, but more importantly, that peak, and then he was afraid of the EE1D. I mean, they know you're there.
Yeah.
They saw you when you peaked.
They know you're there the whole time.
Yeah, anyways. Right. So the EE1D is not going to hurt you.
No.
You shouldn't be afraid of it. You should just, you know, be aware and able to move as you feel. I think that's been highlighted pretty well. It's like, yes, as much as the EE1D makes you stand still if you're trying to stay, you know, unknown to your opponent, if they know where you are, if they've droned you or saw you on a peak or something like that, then there's no reason to not move when an EE1D comes out.
Often they're going to be overconfident, and you can exploit that.
Yeah, I think a lot of players are still kind of scarred from old EE1D.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of smart players just over-peak it then when they pop the EE1D because you know they're going to be a little overconfident.
Maybe. Like I said, because the thing is with the old EE1D, you had a silhouette, and it was obvious where, like, it was basically the easiest thing in the world to kill someone who was EE1D.
Yeah.
And it stuck with you, too, for much longer. Now it's marks.
So it's not the EE1D, it's the PTSD at this point.
I don't know if I want to joke about PTSD, but yeah, something like that. They are definitely struggling with relearning, I think, how Lion is played.
Yeah. And definitely be the case, though, I imagine over time they will get the hang of it.
They will, yes. Now, this could be a free kill here for Neptunes. And it's a little bit of damage done to Thinking, but...
not too much, surprisingly.
Yeah, as he switches to the... well, I mean, that German pistol is not great with the suppressor. Does very little damage, especially through the floor.
It's not Glaz's pistol.
No. No, it's not. That's basically a sniper rifle in your pocket. It's so good.
That definitely would have been useful. Which is probably the best because, of course, with the ability to spot through things and having your pistol out as IQ, it's probably good that the pistol's not extremely good in that case. Especially for Pulse.
Yeah. Well, hey, Pulse? What? Pulse isn't a German operator.
No, no, but he would get shot in the head often sometimes
that would be bad for Pulse. Okay, I got you. That's my bad. Sonics now trying to attack onto ventilation again. This is actually the site where they struggled the most, but it was interesting because they struggled with taking Armory.
Yeah, the one thing they've succeeded in.
Right, they've been so good on taking Armory elsewhere.
You know, that was the first round. First round jitters, right?
Yeah.
Just getting warmed up. They forgot to T-hunt first. We'll see, though. They're still, again, being a bit slow on this. I mean, a little bit more efficient this time. They also had Habana instead of Thermite, and they since switched over to Thermite and been doing a bit better with that.
Yeah, the Thermite... okay, yeah, again, I don't know why the Habana over Thermite. Yeah. Thermite was not banned, and he's so good here on Border.
Yeah. Well, they've adjusted, and it seems to have worked, so...
Yeah, good Sonics. It's going to, I'm sure, assist their Armory take as they try to push Ventilation as site, but, you know, you got to take Armory first. That's going to be Thinking Nade, again playing by half wall, something that he doesn't do when Space Station are actually defending Armory, but he does do if they're defending Ventilation because reasons.
Right? Again, it's one of the safer spots you can be in just due to the operator bans, but...
No nades right now for Sonics.
Yeah, they're not bringing any nades. So
E1D to get the Jaeger to stand still there. So Small Office has a rotation, and Neptune's is going to go inside. He'll, you know, once again get a kill on that push and manages to make it out of Small alive and well, somewhat, on low HP. Thinking Nade aware that he could be pushed at any moment. He's trying to hold the angle. Ooh, what a shot from Neptune's! Big with the 3K, and Sonics have control of the top floor now. Super onto Fultz, and it's just Bosco. He has to deny the plant. He knows that. That's why the impact comes out there to attempt to deny it. It's actually just a goo, pardon me. But it's going to be down. That's two for Bosco, though. He's putting the kills together. Now on the retake, he'll move over to Customs. He knows his position is given away, and he has to go somewhere else if he wants to have any hope of getting this round. Quietly, he maneuvers around his opponent, though it sounds like he's been found out. And there you go, goes down. That's three for Bosco. He only needs to find two more. Neptune's is on low HP. He's playing from above. He knows the advantage he has up there. One outside the window. Goo trap to try and give information to Bosco. Maybe he's going to be a stick, but Neptune's from above. A beautiful round. And the Sonics will take an attack onto Ventilation. Finally, that's three in a row for them.
I'm telling you, sleeping on Neptune's a 4K for him that round.
Jeez, man.
I mean, he just walks. I love how he jumps into Small Office with three people right there.
And he just outfrags him. Straight up wins those fights.
That was kind of embarrassing for SSG.
Kind of?
Just because they got away with it.
Do you mean really?
Yeah, I'm trying to be nice about it, but that was pretty embarrassing. Yeah.
It was embarrassing. They were embarrassed by Neptune's.
Yeah.
Well done to him. He didn't even have much information. Let's break it down. A lot of people just say, what are you talking about embarrassing? Neptune's is just insane. Yes, you're right. He is insane. But the reason it's embarrassing is because that Neptune's didn't have information on many of those players.
He was even fumbling a little bit to vault it.
He was definitely in a, you know, it wasn't a perfect play from him. It wasn't a perfect play from Sonics. Neptune's just made it work because Space Station didn't punish him.
No.
That's it. There was no fight back there.
It just seemed like it caught them off guard so much because it was such a ballsy play to just do that. They just seemed completely unprepared for that kind of move to happen. He did get punished a little bit in terms of health, but that didn't stop him from fragging two more after. So, yep, good for him, though, but we'll see if SSG can kind of pick it back up. However, this has been a surprising turn in terms of how well the Sonics have been playing after that first round.
This is also, by the way, the most one-sided community vote of the day, and it was against Sonics. You know, things aren't over here for SSG, but these Sonics rounds have been looking pretty good.
They're just prepping for the draw. They're setting up those initial rounds
for Sonics. That's probably exactly what it is, dude. That is probably exactly what it is. Space Station are going to bounce back in the second half, and at that point, they're already going to be up like... Sonics will be up like five rounds, and then Space Station will suddenly bounce back.
SSG's social media is just like already preparing for the draw memes.
They have some pretty funny memes over there.
Yeah, they're pretty good at that. Yeah.
Well, Neptune's has been doing a great job on this IQ so far, and he's going to just, keep picking apart the utility. All those electronics being dispatched with relative ease. I say that as he attempts to get the thing through the wall, whatever that is, goo trap probably.
Well, at least there's the pests now he has to deal with as well.
Mindset! Oh, yeah. Pests are definitely really powerful. I mean, so those pests are so useful for multiple reasons, mainly for information denial, much like a mute.
Well, it's like there's a lot of them are in positions where you can detect them with IQ, but that doesn't mean you can get rid of them. And so it continues to deny a drone. But Neptune's, again, using his breach charge as well, a kill onto Bosco. You saw how important Bosco was in the last clutch attempt as well. So that is going to be
a
player off the board.
Yeah, Neptune's has really been fragging out, and you're right. He does get slept on. He's one of those players that I think that doesn't necessarily get the same respect he deserves.
He tends to play a bit more support, too, usually. He hasn't been this game. Like, he's usually on, like, Hibana and things like that.
He's a versatile player, I would say.
Yeah.
He's a versatile player. So, right now, playing on IQ is, in a sense, a support operator kind of.
I guess, yeah, depending on how you use it and how you consider it.
Well, it's a half and half. It's like Hibana, right? As soon as you use your gadgetry for what you need to do, you cease being support and shift into being a fragger. This is a really great push from Thinking Nade. Well timed there. Neptune's goes down. With Neptune's off the board, Sonic's has lost a lot of its bite.
Yeah, good use of the deployable shield to vault over as well. You heard a lot of shots ringing off of it trying to catch him. Super, the EE1D not actually working out from there as he actually gets fired on while he's trying to take advantage of it.
Sonic's have control of office and top floor. Start pushing into jungle. Avian, though, hits a good trap, though. Have to fall back. Definitely the right call to play it safe there, but especially when you have 40 seconds at this stage of the game, they actually don't have control of office. There is somebody from Space Station, I think I just saw, in office. Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed, it's gonna be Rampy. He could at any moment rotate downstairs and catch the flank of his opponents. So Sonics are gonna have to figure out where they want to attack. I think they're aware of this roamer and are thus going to start attacking in through the B bomb site. Probably the right call. Super. On the flank watch, waiting for the rotation there from Rampy, but there's so little time left. That's what makes this really tricky if you're the Sonics. Thinking Nade will peek out and get a second kill of the round. Rampy touched down Super. Super was tasked to eliminate Rampy, but he lost the fight. Chala, C4, and wow, it's just a sweep there for SSG.
Definitely a good comeback on that in terms of taking advantage of Sonics also taking a long time and not having good enough control of any of the particular areas to be able to make an actual adequate push. Being forced to push the B bombs, I like that. Definitely not ideal. I think they were just hoping to get the timing right on doing so. And I think they're leaning a lot sometimes on the Lion to give them free passage into areas. And it's not quite doing that. It's just not a free go where you want kind of thing. I think maybe the old Lion, sure. But this one is just too short for that.
Yeah, the old Lion definitely. But yeah, I agree with you. This one has a, like, was 2.5 seconds or something like that if you include the timer.
It definitely feels very short. Yeah, if you, something like that, I think.
It's not very long. So, good retake there from SSG, I want to say, but it really wasn't. It was just a repel of the attack from.
Yeah, it was just them pushing a little Sonics. More forward.
Yeah, Sonics were just barely into the building on the B bomb site. They managed to. I mean, they didn't really manage to do anything in that round. This is weird because we have like every single one of these rounds looks so one-sided when you take a step back.
Yeah.
So like the last round, for example, the one we just watched, SSG, Thinking Nade specifically, managed to hold on to Armory. And because he managed to hold on to Armory, B bomb site ceased to be an option for Sonics.
Neptune's died.
Yes, because Neptune's died. Because Thinking Nade's killed him.
Yeah.
Like I said, SSG held on to Armory. And because SSG held on to Armory, B bomb site ceased to be an option for the Sonics. They couldn't they couldn't plant there. But then Sonics tried to adjust. They tried to go elsewhere, do other things. Spent a whole minute 20 trying to adjust.
Yeah.
And then they came back to the B-bomb site. But they didn't take Armory. So then they're dealing with vertical pressure and limited time and round over.
So again, that continues to repeat the mantra of what's confusing is they struggle with half wall when Armory is not the site.
And then when it's the site, there's no one playing half wall, so they don't struggle with it.
It's just, I don't know, it seems like it's just weird, especially given the operator bans.
It seems like this could be right now a 4-1, is I think what we're trying to get to.
I don't know, SSG's setting up for the 3-3 tie to bring us to a draw.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's SSG, so we expect it to be a 3-3. But, yeah. I mean, but it could be a 4-1.
It could be.
Because
it could be.
Those two Armory defenses just shouldn't have gone so easily in the favor of the Sonics.
Yeah.
There was, I think, some really simple changes that the Space Station could have made. But it's done now, and here we go, Armory defense. This hasn't been successful yet for Space Station.
And some of that was down to, I think, what we were saying about the way Foltz was playing it, also the IQ to counter Chala's Echo, not to mention him getting down before on it because they know how he plays it. So you might need to change up. Both of them really kind of need to change up what they're doing for this to work, I think.
It doesn't look like there's going to be half-full pressure once again. Because they're not playing there.
All right, well.
So hang on. What's the big deal? Why? So, you know, hang on. Because I can understand not playing half wall at all.
Yeah.
And a lot of teams don't play half wall. But why not play half wall when
it matters?
When it it matters in both situations.
I mean the most.
The most, sure. Why?
Yeah.
There's no C4 from below. The C4 is positioned underneath Archives for some reason.
He's got the Yokai's playing half wall.
It's true. And now Bosco has rotated over, so maybe that's the whole strategy, vertical destruction. Well, Thinking Nade has rotated over to Fountain, so he's going to set up probably to flank later on. There is no Nomad, so that's definitely an option. This is better gas canister usage from Foltz than we've seen from him so far.
Yeah, he's also not playing inside small office this time. He's peeking a bit more around from the bomb with coverage from Rampy, who has now rotated to the half wall. Yeah. So this is looking a little bit better. 50 seconds left, though, so no one has died. So that really, oh, as I say
there
that,
it is.
There it goes.
So this is the half wall pressure we needed to see from SSG every other time they went to Armory. That's twice they lost it because they didn't have that. Avian's going to frag back, but it's going to be an instant trade there from Thinking Nade. And Space Station are in a really good spot because Fultz has been using his gas canisters well, and half wall pressure from Rampy is substantial. And it doesn't seem like Sonics have any tools to deal with this. They're just waiting on angles, expecting Rampy to peek, and I'm sure he will, but there's only 20 seconds left. EE1D coming out. Fultz will get a shotgun rush kill, and he'll finish off Rampy's down there onto Ghost, leaving just Super inside of Archives. He has no chance at winning this round. Diffuser too far to pick up. Three players too spread out to frag, and it's going to be Fultz to get the last kill. A 3-3 in the
first
half.
There it is. There it is.
There it is.
Well, the adjustments, though, from Fultz and Rampy are what made the difference. I mean, it didn't even matter as much with Chala that time. As Rampy backing up from the half wall the way he did, because like you saw Fultz having to play a bit more aggressive, but once Rampy was able to rotate, they instead played it more of a crossfire, and it worked a little bit better, I think.
And here's the thing. Here's the really puzzling thing. Why not do that from the beginning? Because they were doing... No, because they were doing... Listen.
Yeah.
They were playing half wall, and they were aggressively holding onto the Armory wall in a Ventilation's defense in the very first round, and they won that. Because Thinking Nade did a great job of holding onto half wall, he denied that... push from Sonics, and Sonics really struggled to adjust.
Oh, you mean when it was Vents?
Yeah, when it was Vents. And then they go to Army twice. They didn't play half wall very much at all, or if at all. Fultz playing inside a small office also was not great. And it was an easy take into the Armory wall, which allowed for two round wins from Sonics. I mean, you got to give props to Space Station for adjusting. They fixed the problem. They did. So seriously, props to them for that. But, like I said earlier, this could be a 4-1 right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know why I said 4-1. I meant a 5-1.
It would be funny if it was a 4-1 somehow.
That'd be weird, yeah. If we'd go back into the past one less rounds. But no, it could be a 5-1 right now for Space Station. They could have easily taken those rounds, but some poor positioning. Again, though, props to them for adjusting. However, those late adjustments, if that continues to be a problem, then you know where we're heading, Devin.
Yep. Fast track to Drawsville.
Drawsville. Drawland? Land of the
Drawtopia?
Draws. Space Station's home?
From planet Drawtopia.
Oh, I was going to say, if we had a draw for Rogue today, then it would have been them building on that too, because they had the same record as Space Station
did up
until today.
Yeah, they both lost on their non-draws.
Yep. Two draws for each of them and then a loss for each of them. And so Space Station, if they get a win here, be pretty substantial. They'll keep in lockstep with Rogue.
We'll see, though. This is the very first attack round for Sonic, so we don't really kind of have a good indicator how this one's going to kind of...
For Space Station?
Play out. Yeah, for Space Station, exactly.
They set up the impact trick on the Armory wall. A lot of teams do this. Well, I don't know if a lot of teams do it. It is a strategy that you pull out from time to time. The way it works is you reinforce one Armory wall and leave the other one unreinforced, open up a little bit towards the bottom of that wall so that you can impact trick anything that the defenders place on the single reinforced wall, and this causes kind of a lock,
yeah,
I guess, on the Armory wall. It slows down the attack quite significantly, though if there is projectile soft destruction, and there is on Bosco and that Zofia, then you do sacrifice one of those Armory walls, which potentially is enough for Space Station to commit to this attack.
Usually it doesn't matter a huge amount, though, as Thermite often will have a lot of trouble opening that. So
yeah,
it usually isn't a big difference maker. You know, either they have that soft creature or they don't.
Because
you know?
if you go as a Thermite to try and open up that other, the reinforced part,
yeah,
then you are exposed to small office angle.
Mm-hmm.
So it's dangerous for sure.
And usually you want to open up that other side, so it actually can work in your favor the way they have it set up in general from what you're talking about. So
Rampy's in a really good spot. He actually could be in a better spot, though. If he takes into out of ventilation in server, then he can open up closer to the A-bomb rotation.
Kind of buck style from below.
Yeah, he's got the Jackal shotgun. It's capable of opening up some good angles down there, but he's not going to continue to stay downstairs.
Which is probably, I guess, for the best for him, because Mozzie is down there as well. But although, he should be an advantage, because he's Jackal.
He's still down there. He's just not pressuring into ventilation or servers anymore. Castle Barricade tripping up the attack just a little bit here, but it'll get dispatched. Just 12 melees, and it's gone. Fultz taking his time with that. Job done.
Job done.
Oh, another castle barricade. No breaching charge down Zofia, so that's going to be a slow one.
Yeah, definitely not fast. But in the meantime, while no one's actually paying attention, they're going to try and sink the plant down.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Default plant spot, non-accessible because of the gas canisters, and he's going to extend those gas canisters because there's only 20 seconds left. Smoke is well aware that he just needs to deny this plant. Ghost is doing a great job of doing so, and there's also potentially Yokai still in play. Avian by half hole is going to just need to peek to deny this, and he will be successful in that endeavor. Rampy and Bosco getting two frags, though, and here we go. Space Station are on the push, and here goes Avian. A nice one from Fultz, leaving just Ghost and Goddess, but there's so little time. They might be able to deny the plant. It's just Ghost. He's going to have to rush for it, but he won't have the angle and misses a lot of shots by Sandwich. Rampy gets the final kill, and oh, that was devastating for Sonics. Space Station, a beautiful recovery, but wow, it should not have been allowed to happen.
No, it was definitely, I mean, one of the unfortunate things was Avian peaked a little late. He did get the one kill, but the reason I say it was unfortunately peaked kind of late, as opposed to a little bit earlier during some of the chaos, is they were able to close the distance on him. Because he was peaking when they were already pushing into the room, as opposed to when they were kind of standing outside waiting to set up for the plant.
I don't know. That was a very weird round. For sure.
Yeah.
A very weird round.
Well, we'll see how things go down, though, as that was, the very first attack round. And that actually could have gone very south against them had Avian been able to find that second kill and hold.
Yeah,
Avian would have been able to get that plant down.
Avian probably should have been a little bit more aggressive on the half wall, but hindsight's 20/20 on that one, of course.
Of course, and he's not the fast Jaeger three-speed kind of...
Yeah, he's playing Castle. Peak.
Yeah.
So it's fair enough that he decided to try and play a passive. I mean, a lot of players in that situation would have too. I mean, look at the time.
Oh, for sure.
So little. It should have been an easy lockout there. He was relying on his teammates to be able to cover his cross, and no one was. Why was no one covering his cross? Because someone was repelling Sandwich Window.
Yeah. They were just sitting there smacking the castle barricade for the longest time.
Bosco was repelling Sandwich Window. Because he was denying that cross, he cut off Avian from support. Avian should have been aggressive because he was without support, but he didn't know because it wasn't communicated to him. So he played passive, which is the right call in that situation if you have someone to help you out, but you don't. Mm-hmm. You're the sole person to deny in that situation. All your other teammates are being pressured elsewhere. The Archives is being pressured. Sandwich is being pressured. You're even being pressured from the main hallway. It was just a really good collapse from Space Station, a Vitality-esque strategy there, and it worked out.
I think one of the problems, too, is so when they reinforce the one wall, right, the wall that's closest to the door inside small office, what they're allowing is a potential plant spot, right, which is known. Everyone knows you kind of can plant there and you use smoke to deny it and whatnot. But because they're depending on generally using smoke to deny that as opposed to the shotgun trying to come around the corner because it's going to be covered, is then you really depend on the half wall angle to stop that plant then. Once you run out of smokes or if the smokes aren't doing a job enough.
Yeah, but because they've been putting up the shield on the cross, I mean, it's been, you know, decently successful. Neptune's...
Ooh, Pixel there.
Yeah. I don't know why I said Neptune's. I meant Goddess. Neptune's is playing inside a CCTV. He definitely does deserve some credit for the work he's been doing so far. But yeah, playing inside a CCTV, and Goddess is there to support Neptune's. This is definitely a difficult take for Space Station, the way that this is set up right now. That pixel angle is not an easy challenge for anybody. Goddess will have the advantage on anyone who decides to challenge her.
Thinking Nade hoping to get a freebie in CCTV, but I don't think they're going to give it to him. But this is a little bit slowed down by how slow they are in taking CCTV.
There's a missed shot there from Goddess and a missed opportunity. A lifeline, though, seemed to have been absorbed by an ADS. So, some utility burned. Half of the round to try and clear CCTV. Fultz will take down Neptune's, though. That's the player inside of CCTV playing by Banana. Or the big desk.
Looks like they're going to take advantage of that deployable shield, though. Rather than playing just aggressively half wall, they're actually using the deployable shield as well to just continue to peek it.
Yeah, I mean, they don't necessarily need to come off of the angle. Lots of time wasted here. The big thing about the way that they decided to try and play CCTV with Neptune's is that they've lost one of their star players. And the armory wall will be easily opened up by Space Station. Well, actually, the only soft destruction they had was the lifeline, and it's gone.
Yeah,
there
I mean, they
the
could.
Shotgun from Jackal, but he's playing from below.
That's what I was going to say, but yeah, that's true. There's also the shotgun from Gridlock.
True. Exothermic charge goes off somewhere.
Somewhere.
It was a nice detect there. Maybe some damage that could be done from below, thanks to the Jackal. And it will be. Mozzie. Playing by half wall, spotted out, and forced off. Space Station have lost a huge part of their crossfire in sight. It's going to be, or rather, excuse me, Sonics have lost a huge part of the Crossfire Insight. Bosco is also going to take down Ghost. It's a rotation from Super that is successful in eliminating Chala as well as regaining the position that is so powerful, but he'll be refragged by Fultz. So a little time here from Space Station once again on this Armory take, and it looks like Goddess is going to try and punish the time working in her favor. She's actually going to be fragging out right now. One more for her, but Rampy finally shuts her down, and there's another for Rampy. What a flick there onto Avian. Space Station, another last-second attack into Armory working out for them.
Definitely the case where they're just catching a lot of people at the right angles a lot of the time, or we're catching them on rotates, forcing them out of positions. They're not necessarily doing it always even with utility. I think sometimes just the timing is there from SSG, despite how low time is for them to make the actual push.
I mean, when they go for the push, they're winning their fights. That's set themselves up well. Space Station are having a good time of it.
That is at the end of the day what matters, right? As long as you win those.
Yeah, I mean, it is certainly something that shouldn't be allowed to happen. Sonic should be able to lock this out. But it is happening.
Yeah. So one different operator we're going to see is the Alibi here, something we haven't seen yet tonight.
Yeah, she's not often played, especially with the advent of Mozzie. And the reason that she's not as prevalent thanks to Mozzie is because there's only so many shotgun pistol operators you need.
Yeah, that's true.
So many soft destruction operators that you need. And Alibi has become purely situational now. As well as preferential, I suppose. Like, if you want to bring an Alibi.
Yeah, it seemed mostly strong for Clubhouse. But
there's some places where she's good. But really, again, it just comes down to what you're comfortable with. The Prismas aren't very useful. They are...
Mostly just for, like, windows.
Windows...
I mean, like that, for example, he has that one set up to make people think he's peeking. But
Sometimes the Prismas can be somewhat useful, but they're not crazy useful.
No.
The reason you bring Alibi is because she's a 3-speed. She's got a secondary shotgun and
a decent gun.
Decent gun. You know, like I said, 3-speed.
Yeah.
Impacts, very useful.
Sure, sure.
Yeah, she's got a really good hit apart from her actual utility.
Well, thankfully for that, right?
Yeah, she makes her viable. But again, yeah, Mozzie kind of fills a few of those gaps, and there's less reason to bring her, as well as he's a better information operator outright. Yeah. Like, what is the gadget idea behind Alibi? Well, information. But Mozzie's just a better info op.
Yeah.
He's one of the best info ops right now.
Well, maybe they'll do some things in the future to increase the value of the Prismas by making them a little more deceptive, like, say, for example, mimicking if you crouch when you throw them, or, I don't know, I could see some ways they could make them a little bit more deceptive.
Who knows? That's up to you, B.
Yeah.
Now, it'll be cool, though. Now, Space Station, again, slow on attack. They've gotten control of CCTV. They are going to start opening up some angles from that position, and they can later take control of Office, which they see as a hot spot for the Sonics. C4 goes to stop at E-Stairs and misses. And it'll be Amazi who gets punished by Bosco inside of CC, thanks to the angles that have been opened up there. Alibi known to be inside of Archives, and an almost cut off there from Bosco, but he was in the middle of a reload.
It's ironic for having a Mozzie, the droning's coming out really well.
Yeah, the droning from Space Station has been pretty thorough, and it's forcing the Sonics to fall all the way back to site right now. Neptune's the last to rotate, but all four find themselves back on the main floor, and one of them on the floor itself, as Avian goes down to Fultz, who is cut off rotation by Customs and Highway. That's a really good cutoff there, and Sonics are already feeling the punish here. Only a minute left, and Space Station are going to use every second to try and apply pressure from above. Limited soft destruction, sure, but two shotgun secondaries, and, possibly some exothermic charges left that the Space Station Gaming can use.
Yeah, definitely a good position to be in. They also seem to be a bit more coordinated, and that's part of why they've been able to get this far with that much time still left. But now this is where they actually need to start softening up for the execute. Yeah, they only have to fight three down there who haven't taken much damage yet. They're still taking a little bit themselves. But it is 5 men alive, and really that offers you some opportunity for some aggression here if they can just do some additional droning if they haven't lost all those drones yet.
Fultz waiting for a cross. Just trying to cut off between A and B. Charles is going to get Goddess in the bathroom, and there you go, Fultz. Nice push onto the door. Exothermic charge coming out to support the attack from Tellers, but it really isn't going to matter very much. Neptune's the last one alive until we get a delayed kill onto Rampy before having to rotate. So many guns looking his direction, and Bosco will be the one to snag the final kill. Space Station, a very dominant victory there. and their third attack successful in a row, putting them on match point.
Definitely looking pretty good for Space Station to maybe not have the draw, but we could see them stall out here.
Yeah, I mean, it's only going to take a few rounds here, and we will see a draw. So what's going to happen?
Right, this round decides it.
70% of you thought that Space Station would take it. 21% of you thought that it would be a draw. And only 9% of you have been proven wrong so far. What will it be?
Ladies and gentlemen, place your bets.
I mean, they've already been placed.
I know.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say that.
It's fun to say, isn't it?
I never say it.
Yeah. Well, Armory will be potentially the last bastion here for the Sonics. But well, it could be the moment where they start to swing back into their favor. They've tried Armory already twice so far today.
We've literally not seen a third bombsite.
Yeah. It's been Armory and Ventilation this whole match.
Yeah, so Armory itself basically being the focus of every attack.
Volt's having a match there.
Yeah. Not too bad. I mean, we were a little critical of him in the beginning, but he's managed to pick it up since.
Oh, he had a really bad beginning on defense with that smoke.
Oh, yeah.
He was playing in small office, but he adjusted his play of smoke, shifted it to instead actually, you know, his pacing was better. He delayed them. So he learned from that. And then also his positioning of the smoke itself was much better. So good props to Fultz for being able to learn on the fly.
They're really not wanting to have a lot of moving fans in there, which is...
I mean, they are kind of a distraction.
Yeah, but I mean, it's got to be hot in there.
It's a video game.
Oh.
Yeah.
See, I was thinking it was real this whole time.
Well, maybe that's because it's really hot here.
That's true.
It's really, really hot here.
If someone shot the fan here, I'd be pretty mad.
Yeah, for those of you who have been wondering, why are they wearing just button-up shirts with their, you know, sleeves rolled up? It's very hot.
We're still sweating in these.
Yeah. Anyway. Space Station, trying to take control of East Stairs. They already have CCTV. Those are two really good key points for your take. It's going to allow you to really take wherever you want. Office take is an option if you want to shift over to an archives push. Or you could just hit into that armory wall. You've got the thermite, got the XOs. Don't have a Thatcher being brought here for Space Station, so if there's bandit batteries on the armory wall, which there very likely are, then that take will be a little bit more difficult. It's aggressive push here from Goddess. Could net her a kill, also could make her a kill. Wow. Both these players have no idea how close they are to killing each other.
They want to know, that's for sure.
Yep.
But unfortunately, IQ is not going to spot Echo. Nice footprint spot there from below. Yeah. It's always funny how the footprints kind of just hover in the air right there.
And Rampy will be able to detect what I believe to be the bandit, forcing him further back into the site. Yes, indeed it is. I think Nade trying to hold onto the 90 rotation there. A solid position to hold. As well as an angle, I think that's into office. Yeah, no, it's not. It's just to hold the flank. Okay. I think Nade's just holding the flank. That's his job. He's doing his job well.
That's what Goodlock does.
Yep. Well, I mean, okay, Space Station has a lot of control, and very early on at that, they don't need to do anything right now other than start prodding the side. That is unfortunate.
Maybe that'll be better cooked. Nope.
That's unfortunate.
That shield is going to stay.
Yep. And he also got one of his teammates' drones, so unfortunate.
Yeah, Bosco not having the best time with those grenades.
Not right this second.
At least the battery's gone on the shield, if that matters somehow.
It doesn't, but yes. It is true. The battery's gone. Something worth noting. Bosco is going to get on his sandwich rappel, as he has been doing every time they attack onto Armory. Cutting off the rotation very effectively. Shala going for the plant. The gas canister's delaying, but this time there's enough time for, well, Space Station to take their time. Avian will shut down Bosco after Bosco managed to eliminate one of the rotations. That's going to give Avian and the rest of his team the freedom to peek onto this attempted plant. Fultz, who has been having a good match, will stop right now. And he's on low HP as well, so it's getting even worse. Shala goes for a plant. Fultz, though, with the good cover, and oh! He's back into it, and he's got two to boot. Rampy with the cutoff rotation on the main hallway will do no more work after Neptunes shuts him down. This is a potential easy retake, actually, for Neptunes. Two very lit opponents who have fallen very far back into CCTV. One on rappel, and that's going to be Chala inside of CC to get the final kills. CC is the victory as SSG takes this match. No draw for them.
Well, that was very close to creeping closer to that draw, but... Finally, curse broken by SSG.
They got the first win of the season.
Yep.
Woo! Good job, Space Station Gaming. Sonics only won 3 rounds, and they were all in the first 4 total of this match.
Yeah, they definitely did a bit better on their defense. Of course, that was down somewhat, I think, to the operator bans. Just working out a little bit in their favor somehow. I mean, the Maestro being gone, I think, for example, was part of it. But at the end of the day, I don't know. Sonics just really, like, they had some things that worked. But then as soon as SSG kind of figured out what they were doing wrong, they kind of stopped working.
Yep. So. I would say that's a really good way to put it. Space Station were able to adapt in the middle of the match. Sonics did not.
Yeah.
Done.
That does kind of sound. I did think they had a pretty good fight there towards the end. They played pretty good. Avian had a good peek onto Bosco, was able to try and counter the peek a little bit onto the actual wall as well. They just couldn't win enough their gunfights to close that out, and despite Neptune's really trying towards the end there, just wasn't enough to fight too. Had it been one, I think that would have been a lot more doable for them. Just, I know they were both low on health. When you don't know where either of them are, very easy for one of those to get a flank on you.
I honestly did think that that could have been a retake there from Neptune's. He was in a good position to make it happen, but those last two players on Space Station, very smart. They managed to rotate as far away as possible. They both knew that, hey, we have very little HP. Let's play it safe.
All right, well, let's see what SSG thinks. So we're going to go do an interview with them, talk to them about that. And, of course, the man, Lycan. How are you doing tonight?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good. Are you feeling good? Are you guys feeling pretty good about breaking the curse finally? I mean, I guess you technically did with the loss last time, but this has got to feel a little bit better.
Yeah, it's nice to get away from tying in a competitive game.
Now, are you guys feeling like that's going to continue, or was that just the case of this particular matchup? You guys feeling a little bit more comfortable with Foltz now?
Yeah, we've changed some things up. He's brand new, and we're trying to bring him along as fast as we can. He's playing great. He played great today. So, we're just working through, like, our mistakes that we're making. We're kind of like a new team still, so we're trying to make it work.
And one question we had was why you guys were not playing the half wall a lot of the time when defending Armory in situations where, as soon as you did, it tended to work fairly well, even when he was just defending vents. Was there a particular reason why playing half wall was maybe too risky for you guys, or?
No, honestly, it was just a case where we were, like, overlooking the option. On the last round, like, before the round started, we called that we were gonna, like, smoke to be able to run across. We should have done it in the earlier rounds, and we probably wouldn't have lost them, but like I said, like, we're trying to work through, like, the new stuff, and that's something that we should have caught way earlier.
And something that I noticed you guys did a little bit different than the Sonics. So, for example, the Sonics foregoed both the Nomad and the Gridlock, instead went for the Lion. You guys, on the other hand, went for the Gridlock. Do you think comparing those two operators in terms of different ways of kind of denying some movement, you think the Gridlock is a stronger choice?
I think Gridlock's a really good operator right now with, like, her whole kit. She can pretty much, like, do it all for you. And if, like, there's a chance for you to take her, like, you might as well. She can, like, angle hold with the LMG, or she can even, like, push in quickly with the F90. So you've seen that, like, with Uno doing that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I think she's very versatile.
Okay, great. Well, congratulations on your guys' win. Is there anything you'd like to say to all the SSG fans out there who are celebrating your first non-draw?
Yeah, thanks, everyone, for watching. Like always, whatever team that you do support for our fans. Yay, we got a win. So, yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you for the interview, and congratulations again. Enjoy the short break before you guys get back into the grind, and have a good night.
Thanks.